My name is Nisha Zenoff, and my son Victor died from a hiking accident in Yosemite National Park in 1980. And this summer, this month exactly, July, is the 37th anniversary of both his birth, which was July the 19th, and his death, which was July the 12th. It's unbelievable that I've been on this journey of grief and healing for 37 years. So I'd like to share with you some of the things that have helped me along the way in hopes that it will help you in your journey. The first thing I want to mention is staying in touch with Victor. I was a psychotherapist and a grief counselor before he died. And in those days, we thought that it was important for bereaved parents, grandparents, and siblings, and other bereaved people to say goodbye to the person that they lost and to have closure on grief. But now, with all the research lately and a lot of help from bereaved parents, we realize that the most important thing to help us live on after our child dies is something called continuing bonds, continuing our relationship with our loved one, however we may do it. And in my case, in my family, we talk about Victor a lot. He's included in our lives. My grandchildren know about Uncle Victor. They know about his accident. And I feel so close to Victor in 37 years, I have to share with you that the love that I feel for him is stronger than ever. My memories of him are stronger than ever. Sometimes right after our child dies, we're afraid that if we let go of the pain and the grief, we won't remember our child, that that's what connects us to our child. In my experience, what connects me to my child is his memory, of course, but I can see his smile, the twinkle of his eyes, his dimple, his warmth. I can feel his warm hugs, and I stay connected to Victor throughout my entire life, and that's what helps me move on.